Another headache that you shared for
Absolutely.
Quite a long time. You know, the president has said he's been pretty harsh about all the previous administrations, and he, to some degree, doesn't he have a point? Many efforts have been made. None of them have stopped the forward momentum of this.
He absolutely has a point. But I would just say, as I used to say, you know, people have asked me, what was it like to be in there? I said, well, you get up in the morning, you read the Washington Post. It says, the United States of America should do something about the North Korean nuclear program. And you say, why didn't I think of that, right? Yes, he has a point that nobody was able to stop it. But I think the administration is finding out just how hard it is to stop it.
What did you think when you woke up a week ago, or a little more than a week ago now, and saw the president's tweet about his nuclear button being larger than Kim's nuclear button? Was that a wise thing to do?
I've been no fan of the tweets, the policy by tweets. I've been no fan of that. But I also think it didn't deserve, square column inches of analysis.
Nuclear war, though, is a pretty serious deal.
And nuclear war is a very serious deal. But I think people would be mistaken to think that because the president has an ill-advised tweet, we're about to have nuclear war with the North Korea.
Do you have any concerns about misinterpretations or provocations?
I think Kim Jong-un is turning out, much more so than I thought, to be actually pretty clever. The approach to the South Koreans was clever. The decision to go to the Olympics is clever. I think he is more isolated than his father was, perhaps certainly more reckless. I wonder sometimes if he really believes it when he says, I can destroy the United States, because anybody who tells him something he doesn't want to hear seems to get killed. So
yeah,
maybe.
Which is a real disincentive.
Which is a real disincentive,
yes,
to tell him the truth. And by the way, we tried the six-party framework.
Yes.
With China in the chair, Japan, Russia, the United States, South Korea, mm-hmm, and North Korea. I think it's one reason that you want to make this multilateral diplomacy, what's just happened. What the North Koreans love to do is to drive wedges between the various parties. And perhaps
which they're trying to do now.
South Korea. And so you have to be very careful that you don't get into bilateral negotiations with the Chinese or bilateral negotiations with the Japanese or with the North Koreans without really fully integrating the South Koreans, who of course have the most at stake.
You use the word diplomacy. The president hasn't, and you're very close to the Secretary of State,
yes,
Rex Tillerson. You were the one who, or one of the ones who,
yes,
referred him to the president. He was over in China,
yeah,
in the fall, and he was working very hard to try and get some sort of negotiations going, and the president tweeted, I told Rex Tillerson, our wonderful Secretary of State, that he's wasting his time trying to negotiate with Little Rocket Man.
Yeah.
Put yourself in his shoes. You're there with the Chinese, and the president of the United States publicly rebukes you for doing what you were sent there to
do. Look, I can't imagine that happening, all right? I can't imagine it happening with the president that I served. I'm quite sure it wouldn't have happened. I think what Rex Tillerson is doing is just working the diplomacy, just keeping his head down, going to work every day and working the diplomacy. And I think he's making some progress with the North Koreans. Now, it may be that when the president says you're wasting your time negotiating, he's probably right about that. I don't think negotiating with the North Koreans,
yeah,
right now is going to get us very far.
Could there be a good cop, bad cop? I mean, do you think that there's actually an intent here, the whole crazy man theory that,
yeah,
the president's trying to send this message that he actually could press that big button on his desk and that they ought to know that and make it facilitate Tillerson? I'm trying to be generous in my interpretation.
I do think in his own way what the president is trying to do is to say to the North Koreans, you have no idea how seriously I take this. And by the way, that is not a bad thing. And I think it has gotten the attention of the Chinese as well.
Is there a viable military strategy that would not lead to catastrophic loss of human life?
Well, there's always a military strategy.
What's the last clause I'm concerned about?
I really am not inside. It's been 10 years since I had any access to how we might think about what the North Koreans are capable of doing with their artillery. I suspect that you're looking at a really a catastrophic circumstance if you actually do have war on the peninsula. But the military is right to look at the options, because the idea of a North Korean regime